54,864 candidates participated in the December 2023 nurses and midwives examinations across 122 exam centers. 73% of the candidates were females. Among the 54,864 candidates, 349 did not sit for the exams. Despite the substantial number of candidates, there were reported cases of examination malpractice, particularly among certificate program candidates. The board reported lower performance among certificate candidates compared to diploma candidates. Helen Mukakarisa Kataratambi, the executive secretary of the Ugandan Nurses and Midwives Examinations Board, highlighted on the persistent issue of examination malpractice.
Minister, six candidates were reported to have engaged in examination malpractice during the December 2023 MFCMS examinations. These include five candidates for diploma programs and one candidate for certificate programs. In accordance with Section 5 of UNIMED examination regulations, the board provided a fair hearing to all the affected candidates. They all confessed that they committed the murder.
The chairperson of the Ugandan Nurses and Midwives Examination Board, Wakida John, commended the government for fulfilling presidential pledges to enhance the training and assessment of nurses and midwives.
The normal support, the technical vocational education and training achieved, the government has addressed an unemployment gap by providing employable skills to youth at an early age.
The State Minister for Higher Education, John Chrysostom Muyingo, emphasized the need for principals to find alternative fee collection methods after students have registered for the exams instead of stopping them from registering. He pledged to enforce national standards and close institutions lacking appropriate facilities.
Some of the people down there sell all their land, their most precious property. I therefore call upon the proprietors and the principals to explore other mechanisms of fees collection to ensure that our students do not miss their examinations, especially once they are registered and have been learning.
Muyingo urged institutions' principals to work on the declining performance of certificate students. He reiterated the ministry's commitment to continuously review the curriculum to align it with the market demands. Muyingo announced the cancellation of examination results for students involved in the malpractice.
Continuous education curriculum. We are going to be very sensitive to the market needs, the job market. We have made sure we have instructed these people to make sure that whatever is taught to you, to our nurses on training, midwives on training, is relevant to the needs of the current job market. That's why government will put a lot of money in reviewing, implementation of the curriculum, as we've been hearing.
While challenges persist in the education sector, the Minister of Education remains dedicated to uphold standards, addressing malpractice, and ensuring equal opportunities for all students. Story compiled by Sharon Navasidie for the news.